Hi, Paul from Deutsche Auto Parts. Today we're going to be going over carbon buildup on direct injection engines. This is on the intake valves themselves. We're going to be including information about how it happens and things that can be done to prevent it. The problem related to direct injection carbon buildup is a fairly new issue. This is a new issue mostly because direct injection is becoming much more prevalent and widely used across all models, all vehicles. Specifically, the reason why it happens is because on a port injection engine, the fuel injector is in the intake manifold. So as the intake air comes in, the fuel injector sprays on the back of the intake valve. That will then help clean off any carbon buildup coming back onto that valve and then allow it to be burned in the combustion chamber. On a direct injection engine, the fuel injector is inside the cylinder, which means the fuel is sprayed inside the cylinder and combusts there. So as the intake air comes in, the air flows directly over the back of the intake valve and there's nothing in there cleaning it off. The reason why the carbon buildup happens on the valve and the reason why you do get carbon coming in if you don't clean the valves is because of the Pcv system. So the Pcv system's function is to take blow-by that comes past the piston during the combustion process and vent it out of the crankcase. Things that are in this would be things like fuel vapors, oil vapors, and any other things that would be unburned during the process of combustion. That gets routed from the crankcase up the engine and then out in, and then rerouted into the intake manifold for emissions purposes. As that comes into the intake manifold, it will then leave those deposits along the way, mostly on the valves because it is the most restrictive point of the intake track. So here, we're gonna show some examples of carbon buildup on valves. Our first example is of a 2.0T TSI VW engine with 33,000 miles on it. This car, as you can see, has some mild buildup starting, but it's not terribly bad. It isn't going to cause any issues at all. All you'll do is have a little bit of a restriction in your airflow, which can potentially affect fuel mileage. This one's not bad, so it's going to be in a very small way. Our next example is of the same 2.0T TSI engine on a different vehicle with 75,000 miles on it. Now, as you can see, this is a pretty significant amount of buildup on this. It's very visible and it's pretty bad. Now, once it gets to this point, when you have significant buildup like this, it has to be manually cleaned. So what has to happen during that process is the manifold has to be removed and it has to be the valves must be cleaned by hand or by some other mechanism. All right, so what can we do with this carbon problem? As mentioned before, that car that had 75,000 miles on it, it had to be manually cleaned. The options you have in that situation are only to remove the intake manifold. Now, how you clean it is going to vary. A lot of times what they'll do is they will take a chemical, soak it on the valves, and then clean it by hand with picks and scrapers and things like that. Also, another popular solution is soda blasting. This is a great solution. It will get it very clean, but also soda blasting makes a mess. Also, another similar solution to soda blasting is walnut blasting. So they take walnut shells, crushed walnut shells, and use it as a media to get rid of all the carbon on there. Again, it will make a pretty big mess. And you have to have special tools for both of those processes. If you allow the carbon buildup to get bad enough that it has, that you're having issues related to it, like let's say you have 60,000 miles and there's been nothing done with the vehicle, you're probably getting to the point where you're gonna need to clean the carbon off. Now the other option is, okay, how can we prevent this? Carbon buildup can be prevented in a few different ways. The most common one and the most popular use in the automotive world in the aftermarket is going to be catch cans. So what a catch can does is it takes your Pcv system and reroutes your Pcv airflow to where it goes through a condensing can before it goes into the engine. And what that does is as it goes through that condensing can, it will then condense those gases. All the heavy stuff will sink to the bottom, so it'll be full of like oil type sludge, water, fuel vapors and a bunch of other nasty stuff. And here we'll show you an example of what it looks like when you're dumping out a catch can. So there are other options associated with that. Is there are a lot of people who try to run some chemicals, for example, sea foam and things like that. We don't have any claims that we know for certain that that works. That is something that could potentially prevent it. And also, again, just a disclaimer, a catch can will not solve your problem. It doesn't mean that you will never have carbon buildup. What it means is that it will help slow down the process, and so you'll catch a lot more of those contaminants before they get into your engine to be reburned. Some stuff is still gonna get in there, and you're still gonna end up with carbon. It just might last you another 10, 20, 30,000 miles. Other options associated with that stuff is manufacturers starting to test with additional fuel injectors. Some of them, like Toyota, is starting to put injectors in every single cylinder. So on a four-cylinder engine, you might have eight fuel injectors, four in the cylinders, four in the intake track. Some people are testing with throttle body injectors. This way, again, we're getting fuel on those valves, keeping them clean. In the end, at this point, there's no perfect solution for this problem, and all you're trying to do is prevent it as much as you possibly can. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe and leave any questions, ideas, or feedback in the comments below.